universe declares your majesty.
The Power of Truth coming to you from ABN TV channels, Houston, Texas, USA, every Sunday at 6 to 6:30 p.m. Join the Minister of God, Pastor I.G. Fakunle, the Apostolic Church Area Superintendent, Ilesha, Osun State, Nigeria. For inquiries, call this number, +234-906-481-1278, +234-906-481-1278. Remember, it is every Sunday at 6 to 6:30 p.m. on ABN TV channels, Houston, Texas, USA. Jesus is Lord.
Unto the Lord be the glory for the grace to be alive. Real living is in knowing the Lord Jesus Christ. I welcome you in the mighty name of Jesus. Today, this message is titled, Cheap but Costly. Cheap but costly. Come with me to 1 Timothy chapter 5, verse 6. But she that liveth in pleasure is dead while she liveth. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, I want to thank you for this grace to share your word with your people so that they will have life through faith in your only begotten Son, Jesus Christ. Thank you in Jesus' name. Amen. In this context of 1 Timothy chapter 5, Paul the Apostle, he was writing to Timothy on who are true widows. A widow is a woman who has lost her husband to death. Paul wanted Timothy to know those widows who could be honored spiritually. Every human being is a widow. Why? Because we have lost contact with God. The Bible says, your maker is your husband. Your maker, your creator is your husband. Paul was telling Timothy that only widows who are real widows should be honored. And who are real widows? These are those who have served the Lord, who have presented themselves as good examples to all, who have served the body of Christ. That is the meaning in this context. But we want to use it to explain what happens when man discovered the pleasure of sin and goes in for it, swallowing the hook of the devil and landing in trouble. The Bible made it clear to us that sin has pleasure. And why is that so? The devil knew that eventually sin is a deadly poison, but he has to be crafty in order to convince man to patronize sin. Let us see from the beginning the craftiness of the devil in making sin marketable to man. Come with me to Genesis chapter 3 as I read from verse 3 to 6. But of the fruit of the tree which is in the midst of the garden, God had said, ye shall not eat of it, neither shall ye touch it, lest ye die. And the serpent said unto the woman, ye shall not surely die. For God doth know that in the day ye eat thereof, then your eyes shall be opened, and ye shall be as gods, knowing good and evil. And when the woman saw that the tree was good for food, and that it was pleasant to the eyes, and a tree to be desired to make one wise, she took of the fruit thereof and did eat, and gave also unto her husband with her, and he did eat. Look at what the devil did with Eve and Adam. God had told them, without mincing words, that you must not eat of that tree in the midst of the garden, conspicuously located. There can be no mistaking as to the tree God was talking about. It was placed at the center of the garden. Two, God told them that if you do it, you will surely die. That was the instruction of God, because God knew that even though sin was cheap, the price to pay is costly. That is why I want you to pay attention in this message. Satan is a good advertiser of sin, and he knows how to package sin. He knows how to rebrand sin to make it attractive to human beings. Let us see what the devil did here. Number one, he appealed to their senses. He was telling Eve, God did not love you. God knew that if you eat this fruit, your eyes will be opened. That means your intelligence will be opened. You will be able to do things yourself, your own way. He did not tell them that their own way will lead to destruction. He did not tell them that going against God's way will lead into hell. Two, he appealed to their senses of taste and smell. The Bible said when the woman ate the food and discovered that this food was good for eating and presentable. Look at that. The sense of sight, the sense of taste. And up to today, that is what the devil is using. He will paint sin as something delicious. He will paint sin as something very pleasant. But he will not let you know that behind that facade of beauty, there is eternal destruction. Sin is cheap but costly. He was telling them, you will be like God. When you sin, you think you have rediscovered yourself. You are satisfying yourself. But in satisfying yourself, you are dissatisfying God. And when you dissatisfy God, you make yourself odious to Him. You make yourself a merchandise of hell, because the wages of sin is always death. That is why the Bible says the devil has three ministries. According to John chapter 10 verse 10, the Bible said, the thief cometh not but to steal, to kill, and to destroy. It is my duty on this podium to explain to you what are the systems of the devil that made it possible for him to steal, to kill, and destroy people. We are going to consider them one after the other. The first ministry of the devil is to steal. What is that? Satan steals your integrity. What is integrity? It is the quality of being honest and fair. That's what is meant by integrity. The quality of being honest in your dealings with God and man. The quality of being fair in your dealings with God and man. The devil steals your integrity when he makes disobedience to God fashionable to you. You know, there are some people, when you talk of obedience to God, they look at you and say, you don't want me to enjoy life. You don't want me to feel good. You want to put me in a straitjacket. But let me tell you, absolute freedom leads to destruction. Sin is cheap, but the consequence is costly. That is why we need to be very, very careful. See, God had warned Adam and Eve that don't eat that fruit, because it will introduce death into your system. Unfortunately today, many have eaten the fruit of sin and it has introduced death into their body, into their soul, and into their spirit. It is important that you understand this so that we not be a victim. Many today are not listening to God. But let me tell you, don't just blame the devil. If an Adam, they set the pace, they sold themselves cheaply to the devil. How? They added to the word of God. God said, don't eat. But when the devil was asking them, they said, God told us not to eat and not to touch. Exaggeration. And that is one of the problems of many people today. They exaggerate. The Bible warns us that as far as God is concerned, don't add to his word. Don't remove from his word. That is why one of the reasons many people are swallowing the poison of death today is by adding to the word of God. Don't add to the word of God. Don't remove. When the Bible says yes, don't add anything to it. When the Bible says no, don't subtract anything from it. Any addition to the word of God will add sorrows to your sorrow. And any subtraction from the word of God will subtract your name from the book of life. It is very, very important that you take note of this. See, the devil steals the word of God. Do you remember the parable of the sower? You are going to see that when the seed fell on the ground, bears came and picked them up. The one that fell on the rock could not germinate. It could not grow. The one that fell on the thorns was choked. The same thing. The devil is there either to pick the word of God that you have had from your heart, or to make it impossible for you to act on it, or to make the care of the word choke the word of God you have heard. But I want to let you know, sin is cheap, but the consequence is costly. When you sin against God, number two, the second thing that the devil does is to kill. What does it mean to kill? It is to terminate life. That's what it means. When your life is terminated, there are many people, their spiritual lives have been terminated. They have suffered from spiritual strangulation. The devil has choked them. They are dead, but they think they are living. It is important that you understand this. But I bring good news to you. Jesus Christ has come to reconcile you back to God. And I'm going to show you how Jesus Christ shunned the pleasure of sin and tasted death for you so that you will not die. The third ministry of the devil is to destroy. To destroy means to render useless. And that is what the devil has achieved in the life of many people. They are no longer useful for God. And he wanted to destroy them totally. Why? Because he did not want them to enjoy the goodness of God in the land of the living. But I have good news for you. You don't need to patronize the devil and buy his cheap wares, because you know the consequences are great. The Bible says God has made a provision for you. He has made a provision for you to attack the devil and be victorious over him. Come with me to the book of Ezekiel, chapter 36, from verse 26 to 28. Ezekiel 36, from verse 26 to 38. A new heart also will I give you, and a new spirit will I put within you. And I will take away the stony heart out of your flesh, and I will give you a heart of flesh, and I will put my spirit within you, and cause you to walk in my statutes, and ye shall keep my judgments and do them. And ye shall dwell in the land that I gave to your fathers, and ye shall be my people, and I will be your God. Let us now see the steps you need to take if you are not going to patronize the wares of the devil. I repeat, to commit sin is cheap, but the consequences are costly. How do you escape? Number one, go for a new heart. A new heart. You need another heart to deal with God. The first heart God has given you, that is what we call the natural one, has been polluted by the devil, by sowing the seed of evil. The Bible said the heart of man is desperately wicked. Your heart is deceitful. Your heart is desperately wicked. You may say, oh, I am a gentleman. Let me tell you the truth. You are a gentleman because the opportunity to showcase the real you has not presented itself. When you find yourself in a situation beyond your control, the possibility is there that your real nature will surface. Do you know that as many people, they are capable of killing, and they will swear heaven and earth that they can never kill. But given opportunity, they will kill before they know it. So you need a new heart, which only God will give you. Number two, you need a new spirit. Your human spirit cannot help you. You need the Spirit of God. That is the Holy Spirit. When you have the Holy Spirit of God, the devil will have nowhere to hide, to deceive you. Because the Spirit of God will show you the heinousness of sin, the badness of sin, the poison of sin. And you will avoid every poison. And that spirit is the Holy Spirit of God. Then number three, the Lord said, He will also make you to be obedient to Him. God will not force you, but God will make obedience to Him something easy for you, because you will have His nature in you, and you can have that through faith in the Lord Jesus Christ. Even as I'm talking to you now, what it takes to have all these benefits is to simply accept your fault, that you did not commit sin by mistake, but it was because of the infiltration of Satan into your heart. But the Bible said, for this reason the Son of God has appeared to destroy the works of the devil. As you are listening to me now, if you will open your heart to the Lord Jesus Christ, He will enter into that heart and destroy everything planted in by the devil. Because He is the Savior of the world. If you will open your heart, a surgical operation will be performed on you. That is what the Bible calls repentance and conversion. God will change you, and then he will seal you with the Holy Spirit on demand by faith from the Lord Jesus Christ. Don't say, I cannot. You can do it, because by grace you are saved. And by your faith in the Lord Jesus Christ, God has given you the spirit of adoption, whereby you are able to say, Father, make me. And when God makes you, he makes you somebody acceptable to him. Remember, it is cheap to sin, but the consequence is costly. Father, I pray for all who have listened to this message, that they will always remember that it is cheap to sin, but the consequences are costly. Therefore, Father, I pray that you will open their eyes to see the truth and come to you, falling upon their face before you and pleading for forgiveness. Let this be their portion, and welcome them home. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Thank you. May the Lord bless you.
This is the Power of Truth coming to you from ABN TV channels, Houston, Texas, USA, every Sunday at 6 to 6:30 p.m. Join the Minister of God, Pastor I.G. Fakunle, the Apostolic Church Area Superintendent, Ilesha, Osun State, Nigeria. For inquiries, call this number, +234-906-481-1278, +234-906-481-1278. Remember, it is every Sunday at 6 to 6:30 p.m. on ABN TV channels, Houston, Texas, USA. Jesus is Lord.